Next, we'll hear from Stephen Eisman with Front Point.
Yeah, hi. I think it's pretty clear this was a very poor quarter, but there are larger issues here that I think you need to address. Frankly, the only accomplishment that this management team can truly point to is the survival of this company, which I don't mean to minimize, but otherwise, this management team has overseen a massive destruction of shareholder value. In fact, at the current price to book, Genworth is selling at a steep discount to both Magic and PMI, the pure play MIs. And this is probably because this company does not meet its cost of capital in any of its businesses. In other words, the market currently is ascribing negative value to your non-MI businesses. It's a pretty astonishing statement. And I don't get any sense of urgency from this management team as to how this is all going to be addressed. To keep going down the current road seems to me a complete waste of time. Clearly, the best use of capital for this company is to buy back stock when it is at a discount, less than 40% of book value. The ROE on that activity is multiples higher than any new business you can write. So it seems to me we can go down a couple of roads. Number one, you could shut down businesses and use resulting excess capital to buy back stock, or you can give us a roadmap and a time schedule, which we're going to hold you to, as to when each of your businesses will achieve at least its cost of capital. I want you to understand that the patience of your shareholders is not infinite, and my patience is just about done. And I'd like a response to my comments. And one other thing, at the beginning of this conference call, Mr. Frazier said that they might do bolt-on acquisitions. Do not do that. Your stock is selling at less than 40% of book value. You do a bolt-on acquisition, and I will wage a proxy battle immediately to throw you out of here. And I like his response.
Steve, you've touched upon a number of areas, so let me walk through those. Clearly, we are in a transition with different other business segments at different stages of that transition. As we look at the international segment, a much clearer path, a much clearer performance trend. You can also see the path to not only earning your cost of capital in international, but in fact exceeding that cost of capital. And we'll reinforce that as we lay out both where we are and where we're going in that as we walk through the investor day. But I think you can see that in the numbers.
Actually, I can't, but go ahead.
Okay. And we'll make sure we give you if you look at international and where we have targeted in that segment, 15% ROE by 2012, we're tracking right to that. So we'll try to make sure that in that forum we can show all the details and levers that you and other investors can see behind that one.